Hello, this is Amy Zawi with the Jerusalem Connection Report for Wednesday, January 31st, a follow-up on BDS and the arts. BDS means boycott, divest, and sanctions, and in the arts it is usually manifested as a movement where artists will not perform or share their particular genre with the Israeli people or with anybody in the borders of Israel. Last month, we saw a social media war between Lorde and her supporters and those who do support Israel. Lorde is a young pop star who had initially booked a concert in Tel Aviv for June of 2018 and then went on to cancel it after Roger Waters and other organizers of the BDS movement inundated her with letters and calls to cancel. She ultimately did cancel, even though she's keeping her show slated for Russia. Which begs the question, why do those who claim to not want to play a venue because of so-called oppressive governments or oppressive politics, do they then go on to play in other locations such as Russia or for private audiences in Saudi Arabia or other oppressive regimes? Lorde and her 100-plus supporters protest Israel, the only democracy in the Middle East and the only nation in the region that offers any kind of equal protection to all its citizens and inhabitants. But then there's not a peep when these artists do go on to play in Russia and for private entities across the Middle East. Tracy Fryberry of the Times of Israel reported earlier this month on the gains that have been made in the performing arts movement to move past BDS calls for boycott. The CCFP, the Creative Community for Peace, is a Los Angeles-based pro-Israel artist group that offers supports and resources to help industry executives and their clients appropriately handle campaigns against their appearances in Israel. The organization was founded in 2012 after a string of high-profile performers caved to political pressures and canceled their show. Alison Krumlotz is the executive director, and she went on to say that, quote, "We provide a counter to the attack and a balance to the narrative. We may not all share the same politics, but we can agree that singling out Israel as a target of cultural boycotts is not any way to get to peace." When an artist considers canceling a show in Israel, or in fact goes ahead and cancels it, the CCFP has its staff or board members reach out to the artists and their representatives, encouraging them to reconsider and providing them with the support they need to make a very informed decision. They go on to create educational forums for industry figures promoting peace through the arts, such as events held last June at the Cultural Center in Los Angeles, which brought executives together under the theme of using the arts to build bridges for peace. Although such cases as Lorde's make major headlines, such cancellations are becoming more and more rare. In recent years, Israel has seen a flood of veteran acts, which tend to handle the BDS pressure with far more finesse than the young artists. Notably, Paul McCartney, who despite receiving actual death threats, went on to perform his concert coinciding with Israel's 60th birthday back in 2008. He also visited a school in Bethlehem, a music school. Leonard Cohen, who scheduled a 2009 concert in Ramat Gan, in response to the BDS offering calls for him to cancel, not only went on to play, but also offered to play a corresponding concert in Ramallah. His offer for that second concert was turned away. Other artists that I reported on this year, including Radiohead and Nick Cave, merely did not ignore the BDS calls to boycott. They actually responded to it in earnest. Cave went on to say that he thanks the BDS effort in and of itself for helping him schedule his concerts in Israel. The CCFP has tracked more than 1,000 concerts by international artists in Israel, including performers such as Sia, Justin Timberlake, Rihanna, and Lady Gaga. About 30 artists have since canceled their shows, including Elvis Costello, Thurston Moore, and Lauryn Hill. Ultimately, a few reconsidered and rescheduled for a later date. Those included the Pixies and Santana. Eventually, Krumlotz of the CCFP reported, she hopes that her organization will be made redundant and that there will be no need for an organization to help people rebuff these BDS calls for action. While we may not all be fans and listeners to the various artists that choose to play in Israel, the reality is that music is a gift from God, as are all the arts. And it is part of God's creation. Music has been a part, historically, of how we worship God across cultures. And it has always been a way for communities to come together on common ground. Sharing music has to be more advantageous for peace than the banning of it or the self-censorship of where to play it. If the musician is there for the people and not the government or any one government official, agree or disagree with it, the artist should be playing for the people. Shavua Tov. Have a great week.